Stalkup did not develop this condition so you could have a workout in the OR.
Mr. Stalkup's lucky to have me.
I keep telling yourself that.
Robin, the sooner he agrees to the surgery, the sooner he's hitting the slopes.
It is a slow-growing tumor that may not even be life-threatening. There's absolutely no reason for you to open up this guy's brain. Oh, yeah, except for you to show off.
No, I can solve the problem.
So can I, with far less risk, not to mention the expense.
So, what are you saying? The guy doesn't deserve the best?
Oh, why can't you get it? Sometimes the most aggressive solution shouldn't be the first line of treatment.
Why can't you just admit that you hate to be wrong?
Because I'm not wrong.
The role of Lisa Niles will now be played by Brianna Brown.
If you need to get all macho, why don't you go, I don't know, chop some wood or drive a car around a racetrack, but please just keep your hands off this poor man's brain.
Okay, just let me know when the drugs don't work.
Oh, they'll work.
Okay, what about the side effects?
What about the risks in any surgery?
Well, they'll be worth it with Patrick operating. He's brilliant. Why are you standing in his way?
We were just about to get to the good part.
You're lucky Lisa came to save you.
I'm sorry, what am I missing?
No, Robin's done some of the most impressive work just trying to prove me wrong.
We're just picking each other's brains.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
Oh, no, you didn't interrupt. Robin was just about to admit that she's wrong and I'm right.
If you could just get past your huge ego for a nanosecond, maybe you could get out of my way and let me do my job.
Anyway.
Yes, you are in my way.
Security, there's a man with a gun in a patient's room.
Mr. Domestico?
How did you know that?
Okay, why aren't you calling?
The guy with the gun, does he have sandy hair and he's wearing a leather jacket?
You know him?
I'll take care of it, okay?
Okay, aren't you gonna go with her?
No, she'll be fine.
He has a gun, okay? I'm calling security.
You know what? You don't need to do that. The guy that she described, that's Jason Morgan. That's Robin's ex-boyfriend.
If you hurt that patient, my life will become very complicated.
Franco's going after people in my life, Sam, Carly, maybe even you.
What do you mean going after?
He grabbed Carly this afternoon and Sam vanished.
Oh, Jason, I'm so sorry.
And he might come after you.
Me? We haven't been together for so long, how would he even know about me?
I don't want to assume anything, just please be careful.
Be careful, too.
Yeah, I don't know all the details, but it started with Stone Cates.
As in the AIDS wing?
Yeah, he was Robin's first love. He had AIDS when no one would even talk about it. He didn't know he had it at the time.
Oh, so that's how Robin contracted HIV.
Back when it was a death sentence, yeah. Stone literally died in Robin's arms. She was just a high school kid, but she came really close with Jason also.
Okay, how did Robin ever become friends with a guy like Jason?
It gets a little bit complicated. Jason was recovering from TBI. Mm-hmm. He had severe damage to his frontal lobe with complications. It's amazing he has any functioning skills right now. You gotta see his scans.
I take it you have?
Well, that's how I got the poor child in the first place. Robin tracked me down to operate on him.
How long ago was that?
A few years ago. Jason and Robin will, they'll always be close. They respect each other.
Crisis averted. Jason's gone. I'm sorry he scared you.
He just left because you asked him to? You must be seriously impressed.
So I take it everything's fine with Mr. Domestico?
Well, he isn't dead, if that's what you mean.
Not dead is always good.
Are you sure we shouldn't call the cops?
One of these nights over a couple of beers, I'll explain to you the million reasons why it isn't necessary.
Then I guess we are both glad that Robin was here to take care of everything.
I appreciate your decision to not file a complaint about Jason.
No, the last thing I want is a bunch of cops around. I owe you, Doc. Yeah, I'd be dead now if not for you.
No, you wouldn't.
Well, you didn't see that look in his eye. He was gone. He was irrational.
Jason is actually one of the most rational people I know.
Yeah, not this time.
And he wouldn't hurt anybody that couldn't fight back.
Well, I didn't feel that way when he had the gun right next to my heart.
Look, I don't agree with Jason's methods, but he's in a desperate situation right now.
Hey. How you doing, Dad?
damage control?
Do you mind?
I learned a long time ago to never get in your way when you're doing what you think is right.
No.
I know, I got it.
First round on me.
That's not fair because I asked you.
Well, if you hadn't, I would have. I really wanted to drink.
All right. Cheers.
Cheers. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Your boy, Jason, gave me a few dreaded gray hairs today. I would give him the bill for my root job if I didn't think that he'd rough me up behind the salon.
Sorry, I know Jason can seem pretty scary.
Okay, that's an understatement. It's a wonder that poor patient didn't end up with a full-blown cardiac arrest.
Of course, there's always a balance. Patrick told me a little of your history. Oh. And Jason was the one who encouraged you to go on the HIV protocol.
And it wasn't easy. Trust me, I mean, I was lost, I was scared, ambivalent. I had just been handed a death sentence, you know, so why fight it?
Jason had another take?
Yeah. He made me want to live, you know. Jason was so, so patient and kind and just incredibly supportive. He saved my life, actually.
Hey.
Hey.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Don't tell me nothing. You're crying.
No, I'm just teary. Lisa and I were just talking about Jason. Sometimes it's easy to forget how much I owe Jason.
It's not a sentiment a lot of people would share.
Okay, this is on me. I brought him up. I just met Jason waving a gun at a patient, and I was curious. And from what Robin has said, Jason cannot hold a candle to the egocentric flamethrower of love, this Dr. Patrick Drake.
Sure.
Do you want a beer? Because you need to catch up, and I'm
fine. Yes, please, I'll have a light beer. Thank you.
Okay.
Sure, you're okay?
Yes. I'm not allowed to get sentimental every once in a while.
Depends who my sentiments for.
Come on. You know Jason holds a special place in my heart. And hey, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be with you. I wouldn't be here now. I wouldn't be a wife, a mother, and a doctor.
And he gets all the credit for that, huh?
Okay, three beers on the way, and I am betting that Patrick is dying to change the subject to something more of his liking. Shall we talk about you?
It's a great idea.
Yeah?